I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Miracle they said, al suti clarear, lo que erguido se alzó, cuando el sol se ocultaba, y en sus franjas y estrellas, en el rudo luchar, sobre recio baluarte, tallando ondulaba, y en la bomba al azar, su rojiza explosión, en la noche dio a ver que allí estaba. Pendón estrellado, tremola feliz en la tierra del valor y el
class of 2021, please have your seats. I do have to say, it's kind of funny watching y'all swat away the cicadas. Good morning to families, our awesome teachers and staff, our community partners, and especially the class of 2021. Before I start, I just want to give two shout-outs. Mavis Jackson and her team made all the graduations for the last 2 weeks possible, and she's very humble, but please just give her a round of applause. And our two graduation gurus this year who also made this happen, Ms. Tanya and Ms. D, give them a round of applause. Welcome to City Neighbors High School's 8th commencement. Today, guys, is about you. After 16 months, we are here to celebrate you. My speech today is brief. Don't roll your eyes. It really is brief. You're going to be surprised. In 2017, you started as crazy little wildflowers. And today you have matured into brilliant, funny, charismatic roses. I personally am so incredibly grateful that I have watched you through your flower journey. And I'm even more thankful that I get to celebrate with you all today. I promised y'all an in-person graduation, and here we are. But today is about you, about your accomplishments, about your futures. Over these 4 years, both virtually and in person, we have given you the skills you need for the next path or phase in your life. Please go out and make us proud. But always remember, you will have a place at City Neighbors High School, and you are known, loved, and inspired. I will leave you today with a quote. I told y'all it was going to be brief. By Dr. Michelle Obama. Don't be afraid. Be focused. Be determined. Be hopeful. And be empowered. You got this. I love you. Congratulations to the class of 2021. Mr. Bush is now going to give you some words of encouragement.
Man, I was so excited to be here today. I couldn't sleep last night, man. I'm telling you. We've been a journey for these 4 years with y'all, I'm telling you. The class of 2021 is a class like no other. The adversity that you have overcome, the dedication, focus, and determination that you had displayed over this last 16 months to reach this point is nothing short but amazing. Continue to keep your foot on the gas. Use the skills and the lessons that you have learned during this unusual, difficult time to reach new milestones and reach new heights. Go out into the world and give every day your best effort. Think higher. Do better. Be kind. Be compassionate. Your potential is limitless, and I can't wait to see what all you will do and all the amazing things you will accomplish. Please come back and visit. Next, I will bring Janiah Washington to the stage.
Hey guys. Hello, class of 2021. Welcome, family, friends, and staff. Today, we celebrate the class of 2021's accomplishments and the start of new beginnings for us all. And I love to see so many brown faces out in the crowd today because it's been a hard year for us as a race getting our point across to the world. It's been a hard year in general with COVID, the Black Lives Matter, and for some of us, adjusting to returning to the school building after a year of doing school at home. Can we get a big thank you applause for the teachers who had to teach in person and virtual at the same time, because wow. I want to send a very big thank you to my family for always believing in me, pushing me to do better, and allowing me to be myself. I am very grateful to be here because not everyone has a chance to attend a good high school or college. Since I was young, people assumed my future because of my parents' background. They assumed I would not amount to anything, but here I am today, graduating high school with a car, no children, and attending college in the fall. All of us here have had assumptions put on us, and we exceeded expectations. When I look back, I am very fortunate because I have a family that does for me and makes sure I have what I need and want. I will be the first in my family to attend college, and I will graduate from HBCU in 2025. And I know my classmates also have bright futures ahead of them. In years to come, we will have medical professionals, chefs, dancers, first responders, music producers, engineers, and teachers. After watching all the High School Musical movies, entering high school, it was not what we expected, and it definitely didn't end how we expected either. But honestly, minus COVID, and in my experience, it was better because I met new people and had new experiences that have changed me and made me the person I am today. My high school experience started like many others, finding my clique and causing havoc. But when I got into trouble in 10th grade, my confidence in high school tumbled. I felt as if I wouldn't get into any college and all the regular overthinking about life. Transferring to City Neighbors High School in my junior year was one of the best decisions I made during my high school career. my mindset changed, and I started focusing on my grades more in school instead of the social part. Not saying I never had fun, because of course I remained the life of the party. But 11th grade was also, but I knew when it was time to turn that fun down. And 11th grade was also when I learned the most about code switching. Code switching is the practice of alternating between two or more languages or varieties of language in conversation. As a black woman, I already know I will have to work harder than most and always make sure people don't portray me as something I am not. Now, honestly, I hate the idea of code switching, because why is there a certain way a person should act or speak to be taken seriously? I see this in my everyday life, especially when my mom works from home. I be in my head like, she doesn't talk like that, but I'm gonna mind my business. I wonder how she does it for so long, too, because I would have broke out of character after 20 minutes. I also have to understand how my society works. I will need to code switch in some situations and adjust myself to make other people feel comfortable. And no, I do not like it, but having that skill will get me far in life. And I am determined to be a successful black woman. And when I say successful, I do not mean rich. I mean being happy and accomplishing everything I want in life. Because what's the point if you're not at peace? I didn't attend City Neighbors High School for long, but just in my short time here, I've met some of the most creative, ambitious, and determined people, students and staff. And I believe every student that attends City Neighbor High School has the potential to be destined for something great. That person that you think is just sliding through school can be the one to shock the world and bring something great to it. And all they needed was that one adult or friend to believe in them. Leaving high school, I'm mostly happy that I have no regrets, because I'm a strong believer of living every day like it's your last. And everyone needs stories to tell their kids. In my case, my siblings' kids. Hashtag rich auntie. Now that I am at the end, I appreciate everyone that took part in my journey, from family, friends, and teachers, because everyone's role was important, big or small. I wish nothing but peace and happiness to all the members of my class, the class of 2021, and that everyone follows their own path and not let image or money tamper with your life's plan, because other people's lives may look good on the outside, but trust me, you never know, your situation may be better than theirs. And if your speech doesn't end with Maya Angelou, what are you doing? I am a woman, phenomenally, phenomenal woman, that's me. Thank you, and always be yourself, guys. We are fortunate to be a school of phenomenal young women and men. And as much as I love Maya Angelou, I love to invite another amazing poet to the stage. Vay Alexander.
We are the roses that have outgrown the wildflowers. We are the light that makes a way for others. We are lions in this crazy jungle we call home. We are strong separately, but better as one. We are wiser than we were before. We hold the knowledge of many. We have proven to each other that love is shown in different ways, with some greater than others. We have been taught we are great even with our differences. We have been shown no matter how hard someone is on us, the more they care. We are a family stuck together, not by blood. We are a family stuck together by our memories and moments. Sad to say, this is our final stop, but as we grow, our family will expand. We are the class of 2021. We have survived more than most. Yet our family has stayed whole. We are the roses that have outgrown the wildflowers, yet our colors are not just red. You can take the roses out of the wildflowers, but you can't take the wildflowers out of the roses. And we are the roses. Thank you.
First. Good morning to the class of 2021. Congratulations to you all. I want to say to you personally, I wish you much success, much joy, much peace, grit and perseverance when challenges come, and I really wish you good luck in the future. I'm here to present awards to the top 10 of the class of 2021. When you hear your name, please come to the stage. Number 10, Khadija Barnett Goodwin, GPA 3.49, attending McDaniel College in the fall. Number 9, Jalea Dent, 3.49, attending Morgan State University in the fall. Number 8, Destiny Hall, 3.51 GPA, attending Towson University in the fall. Number 7, Shakira Pittman, 3.51, enlisting into the United States Navy. Number 6, Tyler Harris, 3.68, attending Morgan State University. He is also receiving the Kevon Dix Scholarship, full ride, 4-year tuition fees paid for. The next 5 students are the top 5, but also will receive the Merit Award from the district. Number 5, Shamar Hodges, 3.73, attending Bowie State University. Number 4, Shania Walker, 3.82, attending University of Maryland College Park. Number 3, Andrew Gohl, 3.92, attending Dean College. Number 2, Dion Jones, 4.04, attending Bowie State University. And our number 1 student in the class, Amber McKeever, 4.1 GPA, attending Howard University in the fall. Please give a round of applause to our top 10 of the class of 2021.
I wanna leave a footprint on the sand of time. Know there was something that I left behind. When I leave this world, I'll leave no regrets. Leave something to remember so they won't forget I was here.
So, good morning. How is everyone feeling today? I'm great, you know. All right. Friends, family, and faculty, today is a special day where we remark on our accomplishments over the past 4 years here at City Neighbors High School. Now, I need you all to fill me in this one real quick, all right? Dear graduate, curiosity runs wild in the mind of a 14-year-old. We're incompetent. We believe the next 4 years will be an illustrious roar filled with nothing but happiness and reality only seen in movies. We're told that education is the door that walks us through life, so we had to turn it to a key with the world's weight at our feet after we took our first step. See, it's crazy to take in at 14, but that's just a glimpse of the future. We get challenged. Continuously, our school days get longer, the work gets harder, the light gets darker, but we didn't let it stop us. I remember days when we didn't want to be here because we were too tired. See, they ain't know about the ones who work the 9-to-5 because that job keeps your spirit alive. Sometimes you don't want to be home because you know the only escape you have is confined to keeping your body moving. To my older peers, you may have been there before. In that situation where your only obligation was school and work, but kudos to the students who made it work because I know it wasn't easy for y'all. Now, at 16 is when we started to struggle. Depression took over and our minds stumbled. We know the headphones during school were looked at as a distraction to our teachers, but it was our comfort when our mind wasn't in the right position. Teachers didn't know we found comfort in them songs. We had to show them with our work that if we had them in our ears, it'd get done. And if we didn't, our ears compelled our mouths to run like motors. High school wasn't easy, but we made it through. We often lost motivation, and it's natural. It wasn't always slacking or procrastination. We had problems outside the grade book. It was a struggle. Mental health is not a joke. See, some of us found the bricks and built ourselves back up, but some are still trying to find the mortar. I'm not an expert on life, but I know it isn't as easy for some people to recover. For the next 4 years, we get to find our own way, create our own peace of mind, take the time. Along the journey, there will be tribulation shooting from the sky within your orbits like comets raining down in your parade. You might lose someone who kept you grounded, firm, like roots to the earth. You're going to fight battles, but you won't lose the war. It's not the end of your tour. It doesn't always take an army to fight a battle. You just need to know how to hold your own and survive. You'll find your emotions at an all-time high, but it's okay. You can be mad, you can be angry, you can be sad. Sometimes all you need to do is let your tears flow stronger than the greatest rivers. Don't let the world think it's feeble. Listen, people cry not because they're weak, but because they've been strong for too long. There's a whole life ahead of you. It's your obligation to strive no matter what field you're a part of. All right, now to the good part. All right, but listen, feel me. Let's be honest. America is scared. And not just because of the hundreds of black faces standing before me today, but because America is scared of the knowledge you will develop and how already acquired. It's like a game of catch-up. Now we're ahead. Society will do all they can to slow you down. Every time we find our key, expect them to change the locks. Contour the paint until you make yourself universal. So no matter what lock they change, you will always open them. To my friends, my family, my class, you're the key to a new generation. Keep striving, keep pushing, and be the best you can be, flowing with positivity. Love, Tyler. Thank you. And now, I would like to introduce Mayor Brandon Scott.
Thank you, Tyler. And good morning, everyone. Good morning, City Neighbors family. Good morning, family members, staff, cicadas. Thank you all for having me here today. It is truly an honor, class of 2021, to be here with you, and really to be here with you in person, I must add, to celebrate this most important accomplishment to you. I want to thank all your teachers, your counselors, your staff, your parents, your cousins, your brothers, your sisters, everyone that helped you get to this point, because it's your day too. This is a day for everyone to celebrate. But, class of 21, this is your day. First, let me say congratulations, and second, let me say thank you. Thank you all for believing in yourselves and making it to this point. Graduating from high school is no small feat. all of you have overcome obstacles, big and small, including doing something that no one has done before, learning education at home over the internet with Comcast internet that goes out every 5 minutes. You did that. You did something that no one else could do, and that adults, believe me, trust me, I know, they struggle with all day long. You have to understand that. No matter the circumstances you grew up in, your hardship that you overcome, or adversity that tried to keep you from your greatness, you prevail. Today is possible because each of you remain steadfast and true to yourselves and each other. And more importantly, you continue to show the world what you're capable of. And Tyler, they will try to change the lock. But your job is to build a new lock. That's your job. Don't allow them to change on you. You have to build a new world that works for you and for your generation. Each and every one of us, young people, is in a constant state of becoming. Becoming who we are meant to be. Stepping inch by inch into our purpose, our potential, and the endless possibilities ahead. While today you may have finished this part of your race, your marathon is just beginning. Graduates, this is your time, and I urge you today to continue to step into your greatness. You can become whatever you set your mind into. The only thing that can stop you is you. As the great Muhammad Ali once said, impossible is nothing. Each and every one of you has a gift, but there are a few things as sad as life and sorrowful in life as watching someone live beneath their possibility and potential. You must maximize the moments that come your way, and you must stand boldly in the spotlight of your calling, especially today, especially in the world that you live in, especially when you see that folks don't want you to see, and you see that they think that your lives don't matter. The challenges of today require a new generation of bold leadership, and that's you. And no matter what your journey holds from on this point on, every one of you has something special to contribute to the world. You each have a gift and a talent. And with that diploma that you will receive today comes an expectation, an obligation to confront the challenges of today's world. And I know you will. We know, as Principal Zart said, that each of you are known, loved, and inspired. Known to not accept anything less than the best, loved for your spirit and determination, and inspired by your desire to change the world. I believe in you, as in does the city, entire city of Baltimore. I know the future of our city and world is bright because of you. Congratulations, young people. Continue to be great. We can't wait to see what's next for you.
So this is what we're here for, guys. You ready? All right. So I'm going to bring up, as soon as I get to my right page, in recognition of the records and achievements of the students of this class and by virtue of the authority vested in me, as principal of City Neighbors High School, I certify that these students have met the graduation requirements of both Baltimore City Public Schools and the Maryland State Department of Education. I take great pleasure in recommending you to the graduating class of 2021. Ladies and gentlemen, I have the honor of presenting to you Teresa Jones, Chief Achievement and Accountability Officer.
Good morning and congratulations again to the class of 2021! Acknowledging the certification and the recommendation by the principal and by the authority vested in me as Chief Achievement and Accountability Officer, I take pleasure in presenting to you the graduating class of 2021 for the conferring of diplomas and certificates. Ladies and gentlemen, I have the honor of presenting to you Dr. Martha James Hassan, Commissioner of the Baltimore City School Board.
Good morning, everyone. I bring you words of congratulations on behalf of my colleagues on the Board of School Commissioners. I also bring warm welcome from my day job where I'm a professor at Morgan State University. Welcome to all of our alumni and a special welcome to my future Bears. Service is something that people may not have mentioned to you. You're sitting there thinking about what am I going to do, how am I going to study, how am I going to make a living. I'd like to just put in your minds to consider the importance of service as well. And that service, it feeds you, it feeds our communities, and it helps make the small changes that make things better for everyone. That service can be significant and huge, like being the mayor of our city who is doing the tireless work to make this city a better place for all of us. Thank you, Mayor Scott. It can be work of service, like your teachers who are working with Zoomies and Roomies and trying to make all this happen. It can be service in big ways, like serving on the school board, or it can be small service every day, like holding on to that candy wrapper until you get to a garbage can to throw it out, like offering a smile to someone who's sad. You have the power to feed yourself to make this world a better place and to contribute in small and large ways through both your work, your person presence, and your service, and I strongly encourage you to find the space to do that. Today is probably the end of my service. It's the last graduation that I will confer. My first graduation 5 years ago was at Morgan State University to a group of students graduating from City Neighbors. And I walked into that green room and I knew you were different. The preparation you have been given for service and community is unparalleled in this school district. The way your pods came together, I'm so sad that I don't get to hear all your pod speeches. The way your pods came together, the way you work, the way you have been prepared for service and community is unique, amazing, and I hope that you can lean on that strength when times are hard and lean into one another and celebrate when times are easy. So therefore, I will go on and... Got it. All right. So in recognition of you as amazing, outstanding City Neighbors graduates, on the recommendation of your phenomenal principal, and the acknowledgement of Dr. Teresa Jones as the Chief Accountability and Achievement Officer, and by the authority vested in me as a member of the Baltimore City Board of School Commissioners, I take pleasure in accepting the graduating class of 2021 for the conferring of your high school diplomas. Congratulations, everyone.
What a pressure, guys. What a pressure. Congratulations, class of 2021. So we're going to start this process by graduating Mr. Hunter's pod, who is unable to be here today. Mr. Hunter's pod. So on behalf of Mr. Hunter, who's unable to be here today, I take great pleasure in presenting his amazing pod with their diplomas. Isaias Marcel Barris. Jaden LaVon Collins. Shabria Ayana Dunaway. Calvary Jimmy Harris Jr. Jaisha Annette Dingle. Corey Green. Brian Holland. Dion Jones. Sydney Joseph. Shania Embria Mack.
Yeah, I'm ready. Congratulations. Oh, we can do that.
Good job. Elisa McNeil. Amelia Moore. Darius Nasir Roach. And Jacario Roberto Thornton. happy.
Hello, CNH family. We were just laughing up here because after spending 4 years with these young people, I am just as happy as they are. Amen. Amen. So let's get it started. Ayana Campbell. Janai Natalia Clark. Brianna Jordan Floyd. Gary Lee Hawkins the third. Aisha Kanaya Hines. The always humble. Amari Jones Brown. Stay humble. Santi Joyce Lawson. Dion Damar Lopeman. Nashawn Alexander Sneed. Jesse Stern III. Tayshawn Taylor. Jordan Walker. Janiah Washington. Karan Williams Jr. Praise the Lord.
Congratulations, class of 2021, but a special congratulations to my pod babies. I'm so proud of you guys and I love you so much. Our first graduate, Damaris Bears. Devane Lanique Bowser. Nathan Allen Kennedy. Taishe Michelle Cherry. Davon Malik Ellis. Isaiah Lamont Fayel. Layla Yelani Johnson. Tyron Shamar Gardner. Octavian Malik Hargis. Tyler Lewis Huddleston. Taylor McFadden. Reagan McNeil. Miguel Angel Rivero Rios. Anaya Debria Sally. And Asia Elise Welsh.
Morning, everybody. Are y'all ready, Notorious P.O.D.?
Are you? Okay, all right. Fine.
First to go, Taquan Tyrone Allen. Tatiana Zaikia Austin. Sam Berkeley. Lakaya Cobb. Michaela Davis. Dominic Isaiah Dixon. Shintarian Ayana Graham. Tyler Andre Harris. Dante DeAndre Johnson. Darren Kitchen Jr. Kai Lee. Myla Renee Price. Isaiah Nathaniel Williams. And last but not least, Anthony Young.
My pod, what an honor it is right now to read your names. And just to brag, our entire pod is graduating this morning. Let's get this started. Wilbur Perez. Khadija Barnett. Shaquelle Drummond. Niam George Fletcher.
Mama, I love you. That's one for you. Thank you. They said I wasn't going to talk. I was going to do it anyway. Because I graduated, not them.
I love you, Fletch. Lakaya Ariel Forbes. Destiny Unique Hall. Tamara Michelle Hines. Michael Deshaun Holland. Sky Ashanti Lewis. My man, Ryan Richardson. Isaiah McCoy. Samaya Tarita McIntosh. I got this. Amber Shaliria McKeever. Warren Stevenson McLean. Katrina Mae Stanton Craig. And last but certainly not least, Shania Walker.
I've been saving these tears. Yeah, you already know. Gotta anchor this thing down, babe. First, Rachel, Neve, Amia, Alexander. Dantes Brown Jr. Leah Carter. Andrew William Pierce Gall. Shamar Michael Hodges. Everett Adrian Hooper. Malik Bernard Johns. Jalea Lachelle Dent. Shakira Michelle Pittman. Cameron Sharps. Sierra Nicole Taylor. Nathan Scott Ward. And last but not certainly least, Franco Williams.
As everybody can see, we have a lot of amazing characters at City Neighbors High School. So, we're finished. Mr. Bush, you want to help me present the class of 2021? I do ask that everybody remain seated as the kids process out. But I wanted to take amazing pleasure in announcing and congratulating the class of 2021. If you guys can take your tassels from the left, turn them to the right. You are officially graduates. Congratulations, class of 2021! Start processing out. Franco, go ahead. Isaiah, or Wilbur, go ahead. Guys, I need you to process out. I need you to process out. It's not a congregation. I love you, but you have to process out and get your envelopes. Yeah.
Good morning. How are you feeling today? I just wanna lay in bed and not do this. Hold on to my mind before I lose it. Bill collector calling for the fifth time. Wish they get off my line. Dreams when my eyes close, I see myself living life like it's golden. Like that Jill skyline, like the McDonald's sign. Pray to God for a sign. I've been stuck on rewind. Life's a challenge sometimes. Wanna give up, but I know I'm one of a kind. Now I'm ready for battle, so bring out the troops. I pull out the suit. Two me superheroes look like me and you. Ain't nobody perfect, 'cause every day I